brothers and sisters. Shalom, shalom, brothers and sisters. By the grace and mercy of the great spirit, almighty creator. And we're going to get right into this subject matter here today, which is based upon a message to the Israelite men. For those who this pertain to, not all. Your contention and strife and pride and hatred that you are spewing out against each other will be very unprofitable in the moment of most. And furthermore, this is a disgrace. This is not the way that the true prophets approach the matter. The book of Titus chapter 3 verse 9 explains how your pride, conflict, and contention is very unprofitable. It has not produced anything, and it will not produce anything. Many of us have many disagreeables against some of the things that Farrakhan is saying. But on a positive note, at least Farrakhan and the brothers have enough sense to understand that unification is more beneficial and more profitable than division, conflict, strife, disrespect, and hatred, which is the spirit of the demons, which the book of James chapter 3 verse 14 and 15 explains the matter. To whom this pertaineth to, and not all. To you Israelites that are promoting division, strife, conflict, and hatred, you have departed from the true faith of the calling of Hebrews the 13th chapter, brotherly love and repentance. This is not the way the true disciple and apostles conducted themselves when it was sent to convey the Almighty Father's message to the people. To the Israelite man, not all, that are promoting strife, conflict, pride, arrogancy, division, and refuse to repent and apologize and make peace with their brothers, you are repeating the same mistake that the ancient king by the name of Amaziah fell victim to, whose name is recorded in the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 25, verse 27, which explains how Amaziah, he did turn away his heart from following the Almighty Father. Then you go into the Josephus and turn to the Antiquities of the Hebrews in chapter 9, and you read the second verse. Just like this king, Amaziah, like it says in the Josephus, in the Antiquities of the Hebrews, chapter 9, verse 2, it speaks about how he got puffed up. You're repeating that same mistake of the past, which the Most High eventually took him off the planet. And here we are repeating the same mistakes over and over again, which the Most High Almighty Father is totally against. The Most High is against pride, strife, conflict, animosity. The Most High is against us disrespecting each other. The Almighty Father is not with that. That is the attributes of the demon world, and there will be consequences whether we want to believe it or not. The Almighty Father is not extending grace and mercy to each and every one of us for us to hate each other, to sow discord and strife and conflict, and to curse the black woman out. That is not the way the Almighty Father sent forth the 12 disciples and the real apostles and prophets to go to and fro and to communicate and talk to the brothers and sisters of our nation in ancient times. Like it says in Philippians chapter 1, verse 15, some indeed preach the King of Kings even of envy and strife, and some also of good will. And that's exactly what the negative Israelite man is doing, teaching for strife and conflict, which is going to bring consequences upon his soul if he do not repent, humble himself, and forgive. Like the conversation that the King of Kings had with Peter in the book of Matthew, the 18th chapter, the 22nd and the 23rd verse. He told Peter to forgive his brother 70 times 70. So this is what the Almighty Father have to say to the Israelite man that hate his brother or hate his sister and refuse to apologize when we are wrong and refuse to make peace with brethren. Okay? Romans chapter 2, okay, verse 8, is the final destiny of those that like to exalt evil, division, strife, conflict. But unto them that are contentious and do not obey the truth, but obey unrighteousness, indignation and wrath. So that's the final destiny. Because Proverbs chapter 6 verse 16 on down to the 19th verse, the Most High clearly explains some of the things that he hates, such as a proud look, wicked imagination, and those that are sowing discord and strife and teaching other brothers to hate other brothers and teaching other sisters to hate other sisters. When Isaiah came into Jerusalem over 2,000 years ago, the Most High told him to exalt his voice like a trumpet and show the house of Jacob their sins and their crimes, such as fornication, adultery. They was into murdering each other. Some of them were sleeping with each other's wife, as it still remains here today. Some of them was in human sacrifices and into witchcraft. And Isaiah was sent to tell the brothers and sisters in ancient time to stop doing these things and to repent, lest the Most High judgment come upon their soul. But on the other side of the coin, for those that humbled themselves and repented and was remorseful for their crime, this is the message that the Most High told Isaiah to convey to those brothers and sisters. Comfort ye, Isaiah 40:1. Comfort ye, my people, saith the Creator. Second verse. Speak ye comfortably, not F-U-C-K, to Jerusalem, and cry unto her, that her warfare is accomplished, and that her iniquity, her crimes, her sins, is pardoned, meaning the Most High is going to forgive us, okay, if we repent, okay, and bow down to what he's saying, and make peace with him first, and peace with each other. For she have received of the Most High hand double for all her sins. What is this double that we have received? Slavery, disrespect, okay, being kicked out of our land, losing our culture, losing our language, losing our true heritage. The division between the man and the woman, that's all the curse of prophecy that's recorded in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 56, where it states how the woman, I, shall be evil towards her husband because of the man's disobedience against the Creator. That's the curse of judgment that came upon our soul. But moving further on with the program concerning the protests of our brothers and sisters in Michigan, okay, who are protesting for basic survival, how everything is being cut, and the reason why we've been suffering so long, and while we're going through these things, what have we done? This is the way the true prophets came to the people to explain the situation of the matter. Why we're suffering so long. What happened? What did we do? 2 Ezra chapter 10, verse 25. Seeing ye have forsaken me, we have forsaken the one that have created us. This is the way it's supposed to be explained to the people. Not cursing them out. Not beating them down. That's not the way Isaiah and Jeremiah and Ezekiel and Daniel's dealt with the people. Seeing ye have forsaken me, we have forsaken the one that wakes us up on an everyday basis. We have forsaken the true authority that's responsible for our existence. I will forsaken you. The Most High have turned his back on us because we have disrespected the rules and regulations that he gave our ancient ancestors that was supposed to be passed down to our generation, how we are required to live our life. The same exact way when this whole entire universe was brought into existence in the earth, in the ocean world, it was encoded with natural rules and regulations. And when you go against those natural rules and regulations, you're going to have repercussions. You don't respect the ocean water is not going to respect you. You're not going to respect the universe is not going to respect you either. As a matter of fact, the universe is going to strike back and fight back, where that same concept of understanding was given to us when we was created. The Most High created us with rules and regulations, do's and don'ts. Seeing you have forsaken me, so we have forsaken the Almighty Father. And some of us are saying that there is no greater power than man, and that we're not going to respect the fact that there's a greater immortality power greater than man. And these are the repercussions coming down the pipeline upon our heads called natural disasters. Seeing you have forsaken me, I will forsaken you also. This is the 7th century prophecy of the prophet Ezra. When ye desire me, in 2 Ezra chapter 1:25, when ye desire me to be gracious unto you, when we're in the hospital, when we got plugs coming out of our ears and our nose, when we desire the Most High to be merciful to us, when we're on our deathbed, okay, after disrespecting him, practically all our life that we've been on the earth, for those who this it pertaineth to, when ye desire me to be gracious unto you, I will have no mercy unto you. For that is the message that the Most High sent the true ancient prophets and apostles to convey to our ancient ancestors, male, female, and child, when they began to go into supreme evil and wickedness. Not to go into the ancient cities and villages in ancient times to curse them out, to use all kind of vulgar language. The Most High is totally against that. And the Most High is going to charge the Israelite man that's doing such thing. All the prophets could do in the ancient times was warn the people and tell the people, stop hating your brother. Stop disrespecting each other. Stop sleeping with each other's wife. Stop the killing each other. Stop killing your babies. Stop doing all kind of immoral, evil things against your little babies, your sons, and your daughters. And stop disrespecting the creator of the universe and bow down to repentance and acknowledge that we are in default. And that's the reason why we're suffering temporarily. And the Almighty Father has required us to repent and acknowledge that we are wrong before the Most High removed his mercy, okay, away from us, which a lot of us, we have exhausted that mercy. And if anybody is really paying attention, the 7th century prophet Ezra, he spoke about this catastrophic solar flare storm that could knock out everything that is driven by electricity. As 2nd Ezra chapter 15, 38 proclaims, and there shall come great storms, like the talk of the coming of a solar storm attack. Now, what is the reason for this solar storm attack? This is a repercussion for violating and disrespecting this earth and the universe, and disrespecting those natural laws that the Almighty Father have encoded inside this universe, which man is supposed to respect, which he has disrespected. Luke chapter 21, 25 states that there would be signs in the sun, like the solar flares emitting from the sun, which they're talking about, and how these solar flares could cause an electromagnetic effect against the world. It's like a domino effect, where one thing can affect something else, like dominoes falling down. You're talking about solar flares, okay? You're talking about fiery balls coming out the sky, okay, on Earth, smoking people out of existence. You're talking about satellites dropping out of the sky. You're talking about everything that's driven by electricity, okay, being shut down. You're talking about no lights. You're talking about the transformers being burnt out, okay, like a smokestack. As some of you Israelite brothers continue to strive in conflict against each other, into war against the other brothers and sisters and cursing them out and using YouTube as a platform to disrespect each other, which the Most High is against that type of behavior. The Most High is looking at all of us and he hates that type of conduct and character. And let us not think, because we come from the seed of Jacob, that we have some special privileges to say and do what we want to do. We better go back and do a reality check and check out the history of those ancient Hebrew Israelite kings and how the Most High laid them all down to the deathbed slaughter for the same strife, conflict, and evil things that we're doing against each other. Like it says in Leviticus chapter 26 and 23rd verse, and if ye will not be reformed, for the Most High has given us mercy to reform, to transform, to change our ways. You can't say what you want to say and do what you want to do. Well, we can try it, but there's going to be repercussions in the end. Just like in ancient times. And if you will not be reformed by me, by these things, meaning taking reproof and correction and repentance, but will walk contrary unto me, and when you hate your brother, we're walking contrary against the Most High. And when we're hating our sister, we're walking contrary against the Almighty Father's instructions concerning the situation with the so-called black woman. She's suffering from the curse of Deuteronomy chapter 28 and 28. And the only way she's going to be healed is through the prophecy prediction of Jeremiah chapter 31, okay, and 32 on down. The Most High is going to have to, okay, restructure her mind and heal her thoughts and to show her how to be a woman again. And it's not going to come through cursing her out. You see, of course we know most of the people is not going to listen and not respect this. But just like the ancient prophet came in the 6th and 7th century, they came to warn the people and to convey the message that the Creator told them to tell the people when they went into deep darkness. And those prophets and those true apostles and disciples, they had to walk a certain way. They had to be an example of what they were talking about. They were not to be high-minded and proud and arrogant. They were not to sow discord and strife. They was not sent to curse the so-called black woman out, but to tell her right from wrong, and just to convey the message, okay? And their job was done. Leviticus 26 and 23rd verse. And if ye will not be reformed, this is why we're suffering, by me, which is temporarily, by these things, but will walk contrary unto me, as we still are doing here today, as we're saying that the Creator is not to be respected and that he doesn't exist. You got a group running to and fro talking about there's no greater power than man, just like Nimrod was doing in ancient Babylon. And that's the reason why his kingdom was brought down, and many other evil reasons as well. 24 verse. Then will I also walk contrary unto you. So the Almighty Father is going to walk contrary to us and will punish you. A lot of us will be punished, whether we believe it or not. Yet seven times for your sins, just like in ancient times, the 25th verse, and I will bring a sword upon you. This is the way the prophets came to our ancestors when they began to commit all these evil crimes against each other and the Creator. And of course, they didn't like it. That's why some of the prophets, okay, died by the hands of these evil ancestors. And I will bring a sword upon you and shall avenge the quarrel of my covenant. And when ye are gathered together within your cities, when we were once in our cities, which we don't have our own cities anymore because of disrespect against the Creator, I will send a pestilence among you, and ye shall be delivered into the hands of your enemies, as it still remain here today, whether we want to believe it or not. You see? So it's a wake-up call that the prophets and the true disciples and the apostles like Enoch came to convey to the people, to give them this message. Our condolences go out to the sister whose son was murdered, because that's one of us. Trayvon, who was killed in Florida. Just like for February the 6th, there's another brother, 18 years of age, by the name of Romali Graham. He was shot down, okay, he was unarmed, by so-called NYPD. Like the situation that happened with our brother in Savannah, Georgia. Okay. Troy Davis, who was also murdered. Like it states in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 30, verse 7, it is a time of our trouble. This is not happy hour or time to barbecue. They're talking about meteorites coming to hit this place because of the great disrespect against the universe and the earth. It's a living entity. It feels, it breathes. The natural science that's encoded inside the universe says, if you respect me, I'm going to respect you. But if you don't respect me, I am not going to respect you. And the repercussions are recorded in the book of 2nd Ezra, verse 38, which states this: and then shall there come great storm, like recently the storm that they had in Indiana. And then shall there come great storm, like the solar storm that they're talking about, okay, that they're saying is inevitable because there's a hole in electromagnetic field. What are you Israelites going to do for those who this pertain to? You're going to keep fighting against each other, okay, when a meteorite come out of the sky? Or if a solar storm come out the sky, knocking out the satellites and knocking out all the electricity, you're going to continue to go to war against each other? And then shall there come great storms from the south and from the north, another part from the west. And why are these things are happening? Why is there such intensity with the weather, with the hurricanes? This is a sign, not only the solar flares emitting from the sun, but the intensity of the hurricanes is a sign for all of us, whether it's our cousins, our mothers, our fathers, our nieces, our nephews. This is not by coincidence, okay? You check out the graphic charts of the hurricanes, and they are intensifying. This is a sign, a message from the throne of the Most High for us to get it together. Lest we find ourselves getting caught up, getting slammed down by the meteorite. There's no respect to person when it comes to right and wrong. And then shall there come great storms from the south, just like the storm that hit Tuscaloosa, Alabama, which looked like a nuclear bomb hit certain communities. So for the Israelite man, for those who this pertains to, that's continuing this path of sowing discord and strife and cursing their brothers and sisters out, which the Most High is in total disagreement against, there's a great possibility that you might be bringing judgment on your head instead of mercy, grace, and salvation. This is the message that the Most High have to tell us all. He's not playing no games. In order for the Most High to extend his mercy to us, his requirements is that we got to love each other. We got to respect each other. We got to forgive. Okay? We got to say what the Most High have told us to say. We can't say what we want to say. We can't mistreat people. Of course, we got to deal with the right and the wrong. Of course, we know most people ain't going to listen. Of course, we're not supposed to try to force this on nobody. People can make their own decisions. People can do whatever they want to do. It's their choice, just like they made their decision in the ancient world, in Babylon, the Samaritan kingdom, the Egyptian kingdom, the Persian Empire, the Greek Empire. They made their own decisions. And the own decisions that they made, it brought their own demise upon them. But we have to clean up. We got to break up our fallow ground. Okay? This thing is coming down, man. Father is upset with all of us that are promoting evil. Whether it's our mother, whether it's our grandfather, okay, whether it's our niece, our nephews, our uncles, whether we in America, whether we in England, whether we in London, whether we living in Europe, whether we living in South America, whether we living in the Caribbean islands, wherever we are at this present time, let it be known to all of us, starting with myself first, the Most High Creator of the universe is very upset concerning how we are disrespecting each other, how we are mistreating each other, how we are seeking to do bodily harm against each other, whether verbally or physically, and the time is going to come where the Almighty Father ain't going to take it anymore, and his hand is in the earth. No matter how many people try to disrespect and deny, okay, that the things that's coming in this earth is being initiated from the ancient, supreme, immortality, majestic, okay, angelic force. So, if we don't learn before the Almighty Father make his second day appearance with his high-ranking chief ambassador, if we don't learn to make these adjustments of respecting each other and learn what it means to love each other in deeds, okay, and action, the day will come where the Most High will disappoint us. And that same boomerang that we throw out against each other, that same boomerang of evil, conflict, is going to come right back on our neck like a man's head being put inside a guillotine. And of course, I'm going to repeat this once again. This message is not for everybody. It's not for everybody. It is not for everybody. It's only for a few people, okay? The prophets told us in ancient times that this message is only for a few people. Most of the people is going to reject this message. It was written and foretold in the ancient scrolls of Ezra, going back to the 6th and 7th century, which they found in the Judean desert, okay, which they call the 2nd Ezra, the 7th chapter, and the 23rd verse explains this matter, how they deceived themselves by their wicked deeds and said of the Most High that he is not. In other words, the Creator don't exist. There's no greater power than man. So as it has been written, with so-called Phil Valentine try to discredit, so must it be fulfilled. So what if they don't believe? So what if they don't believe? Exactly, just like ancient king wicked Nimrod didn't believe. When everything narrowed down to the wire, Nimrod and his kingdom was taken out of existence. So what if they don't believe that Sodom and Gomorrah did exist, and that there's enough evidence to prove that what's described in the scrolls, which they found in the Judean desert and many other different areas on this planet, okay, did happen, and there's much evidence to prove okay, by different archaeologists, that brimstone and fire was rained upon Sodom and Gomorrah, and they found different samples of the sulfur. Okay, and they took the sulfur in the laboratory to examine it. Okay, and some of the sulfur samples that they took, okay, in the area called the Dead Sea, okay, it burnt right through the spoon. And there's an archaeologist by the name of Ron Wyatt. Him and his wife in the 1990s, they took different samples of sulfur and brimstone and they tested it in the laboratory. And they witnessed that there was certain houses in that area, okay, defining that that was once a city. And you can smell the sulfur stench in that area. And not one blade of grass would grow in that region. Because the Most High marked that place as a memorial for the things that they were doing, okay, which they're still doing here today in this 21st century, which was displeasing against him, which many will deny. So to the Hebrew brother man, okay, this is directed to you. They like to fight against your brothers and disrespect your people, even the ones that's not awoken yet, which the Most High can wake them up, which that's very ignorant to do. Because we don't know who the Most High is going to destroy and who the Most High is going to save. And I tell you this, the Most High is coming back for the humble and the meek. Oh yeah, the Most High love the meek and the humble. The Most High hate the proud and arrogant and the high-minded. The Most High don't like discord and strife. That makes the Most High very angry. And it makes him so angry that there's going to come a time when the Most High will. And it's going to take this. The Most High is going to command certain hurricanes to come inside some of our living room in our bedroom. The Most High may command a meteorite to come slam down right on our heads if we don't change our ways. That's how upset the Most High is. So it's all about brotherly love and wisdom, knowledge and understanding. And sisters to us as well. We love y'all. You see? Y'all part of us as well. Because sometimes we leave the sisters out. And we know there's a few sisters that are trying. They're trying to do what's right. They're not down with all this evil, man. They're not into this immorality. And a lot of them are low-key. They're not perfect, just like we ain't perfect, man. We all in this together. And our sons and daughters, too. They got it bad. They can't even enjoy their childhood because they are being born in an era where we're entering into the times of tribulation. You see? One of the main things that the Most High is going to hold us accountable and charge us on is, do you love your brother? Do you love your sister in this lifetime? What did you do in this lifetime while we was on the earth in the flesh? Did you work out your differences? Did you learn to love your brothers? Did you learn to forgive your brothers? Did you learn to forgive your sisters? Did you learn to be courteous? Did you learn to be charitable? Okay, let me rephrase that. Did we learn to be charitable? Did I learn to be charitable? Did I sow hatred inside my heart? Did I sow discord inside my heart? Did I teach other brothers to hate other brothers? That's what the Most High is going to charge us on when we go before his throne. Do you love your brothers? Do you love your sisters? Think about it. Tomorrow ain't promised to none of us. Love your brothers. Do you love your sisters? Think about it. Tomorrow ain't promised to none.